Hi everyone, I am Asha, and today I'm going to talk a bit about the embedded engineer interview process. At the end of this video, you should have a very good understanding of the process itself, what interviewers filter for, and several tips on preparing yourself for this. Quick intro. I'm from Prepfully. This overview has been put together by embedded engineers who are also interview coaches on Prepfully, the very same ones who have helped hundreds of candidates with mock interviews and advice. This is a video version of our much more in-depth written guide, which we link within the description. And you can always book time with the coaches directly and for more personalized guidance on Prepfully's website. Right, on to the overview now. There are three primary rounds to the embedded engineer interview. First, the phone screen. Next, the main on-site interview, which comprises of four rounds itself: general programming, embedded system design, and behavioral. And finally, the third and the last, HR round. Let's take a look at each round. The phone screen is typically a brief 30-minute pre-screen to assess the candidate's suitability for the role. Questions asked revolve around your background, qualifications, and motivations for applying for this role. A few points to remember here. Be ready for the ever-popular "tell me about yourself," since this interview nearly always kicks off this way. The phone screen is a brief 30-minute call, so keep your answers short and focused. Think ahead and decide which specific projects you are going to talk about. Focus on what your contributions were, any challenges that you faced, and how you could improve. Candidates have reportedly been asked generally easy programming questions. Practicing a few LEET code questions should be enough. Be ready to talk about your genuine interest in the embedded engineer role and why you want to work at that specific company. Right then. Next is the on-site interview. There are up to five different interviews in this round. Let's look at each one of these one by one. First, there's the general programming interview. Two things that you ought to know about this round. It is a solely programming-focused interview round, so be ready to solve coding problems and demonstrate problem-solving skills. Make sure that your review programming concepts, such as data structures and algorithms, and practice coding problems related to embedded systems. Questions typically asked fall in the LEET code medium difficulty range and involve coding in C or C++. Make sure that you have a good grasp of data structures, particularly trees and linked lists. Next up, the embedded programming interview. This round comprises both in-domain programming questions and theoretical questions related to embedded systems. Here are my tips to prep for this. First, on-domain programming questions focus on your ability to work with the specific tools and technologies used in embedded system development. So if possible, practice coding on real hardware development boards like the Arduino or Raspberry Pi to get a better understanding of how these tools work. Practice coding problems related to embedded systems, such as implementing a circular buffer or a bit manipulations operations. Review data structures like arrays, linked lists, and queues, and learn how algorithms like sorting and searching can be optimized for embedded systems. Secondly, theoretical questions will assess your knowledge of embedded system concepts and principles. So familiarize yourself with hardware interfacing techniques such as pulse width modulation, analog to digital conversion, real-time system concepts such as interrupt handling, scheduling, and debugging tools, etc. One way to prepare for an embedded engineering interview is by reviewing typical embedded system interview questions and model responses, which can help candidates prepare impressionable responses for questions they might encounter. You can look up commonly asked embedded engineer interview questions on places like Glassdoor, TeamBlind, or interview preparation platforms like Prepfully, which also offer mock interviews to help you practice your interviewing skills. Moving to the third round, the embedded system design interview. Basically, it is like a classic system design interview, but the focus is on your expertise in embedded systems. To give you an example, the interviewer may present a scenario such as designing an embedded system that can control the temperature of a refrigerator, and then ask you to walk him through the design process. Here's how I suggest you approach this round. The goal is to demonstrate your expertise in interfacing with hardware different components and optimizing code for performance in an embedded system. This one is important. Make sure you ask clarifying questions, the more the better, to demonstrate the depth of your understanding of the subject. So start by gathering data as much as possible, then break the problem down into smaller components, and then design each component while considering its impact on the overall system. You should be able to make trade-offs between different design decisions and justify those choices. Communicate your thought process throughout. It's okay to mention areas where you lack expertise and instead focus on areas where you are the more knowledgeable one. I'd also suggest practicing the system design interview in an interview-like setting, which has all the stresses and the curveballs of a live interview. Prepfully has several embedded engineers from top FANG companies who can help simulate this interview atmosphere, and you can book time with them directly. The advantage of practicing through a mock interview is that when you are getting specific feedback on how you perform from a field expert from your target company, it helps. This can help you even more confidently address questions interviewers might throw at you in a way that demonstrates your skills in the most effective way possible. Right then, on to the final round of the on-site interview, the behavioral round. This one will focus on your past experiences and projects and your soft skills like critical thinking, communication skills, and problem-solving skills. The interviewer might ask you to talk about a project where you had to optimize performance and efficiency in a real-time embedded system. You're expected to explain how you proceeded to do so. Make sure that you think ahead and decide which specific project you will talk about that best showcases the relevant skills and the competencies that the interviewers are looking for. Right, that is all from us. Lots of additional resources, including a written guide and interview questions, in the description. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you and good luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.